Hi, I'm Emma Katiraee, a certified Dubsado specialist, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create an email signature that you can use in Dubsado. And we're going to go about it two different ways. One is to create it in Canva, where I am right now, and the other is to use an email signature generator. So let's get started. In Canva, all you're going to do is you're going to go into the search bar up here in the homepage, and you're going to type in email signature. And as you can see, there are a lot of options here. So choose the one that works best for you. I recommend keeping it simple, having a white background so that it blends more seamlessly into the emails that you're typing, because it won't span the entire width of the email. It's just an image at the very bottom left, I should say. So that's why I personally keep a white background, but you can do whatever, you know, you want. There's no rules here, so that's just my recommendation. But if you want to have a background image, you want to use something like this or like this, feel free to do whatever you prefer. So I'm just going to go with this simple one here. And if you look at the size of this file, it's 400 by 200. If you can, if you have Canva Pro, I would suggest switching this to 600 by 300 and just resizing it. It's going to look exactly the same, but it's just going to look more crisp. And when you make the email signature a little bit larger in Dubsado, it won't look as blurry. So I'm just going to delete this background, and I'm going to turn this into my email signature. So now I don't use my phone number in my email signature, nor do I display my address, but I will use my email. So I'm just going to search for a better icon. I prefer the ones that are like this, that don't have color in the background. They sometimes get a little bit blurry. So now I'm going to look for similar icons for things like website, Facebook, Instagram. Because none of these links are clickable, you're going to download this as an image. And when you insert it into Dubsado, you can only use one link for the entire image. That's usually a website, but it's up to you. You can link it to your Facebook account or your Facebook page, sorry, or your Instagram profile. It's up to you. So now all I'm going to do is line these up correctly. So I'm just going to group each one of these. And now I'm going to set the bottom one at the bottom corner, and then the top one where at the highest spot I want them. And now I'm going to select them all and position space evenly vertically. And so it looks a little bit tidier. So this is basically what an email signature image would look like using Canva. You're just going to download it as a JPEG or a PNG, whichever you prefer. Don't use a transparent background. Keep the background whatever color you're using. And then just click share, download, and then click download again. If the size of the image is too large, because you don't want something too large to be sent with every email that's going out, you can use a site like TinyJPEG to shrink the size, to compress it before you put it into Dubsado. Now in Dubsado, you're going to go to canned emails and you're going to click signature. And you're going to go here to the formatting options and go and select insert image. And you're going to drag the image that you made into this box here. There you go. So now you can resize it. If you just click on it and you click change size, you can make this about 400. That's about as, that looks pretty good. And if something doesn't look right to you here, you can go to Canva, make changes, and download it again. And then if you want to make this clickable, like a link connected to this image, you're just going to insert that link here. And you can click, I would recommend clicking open a new tab, because they're going to be seeing this like inside their Gmail or wherever. So you want it to open a separate tab so that they don't lose their email. And click insert and done, and click save. So now if you go to projects, I'm going to go, this is my sample client that I have in my test account. I'm going to send email. You can send it to yourself to test what it looks like what a client would be receiving on their end, just to make sure that it works. You don't want to make it larger, smaller. You can play with all of those settings inside of Dubsado, or you can download, make changes in Canva and download it again until it's something that you're happy with. So that's how you do this in Canva and then going into Dubsado. So now we're going to create an email signature using an email signature generator. I have tested a lot of email signature generators and I've always been frustrated by them. I sign up for their free version, and then when you go in and you try to create an email signature with their free version, there's always elements that you cannot use in the free account that you have to sign up for the pro or paid account. And I simply haven't wanted to do that. So what you're left with in the free version is very limited, and it's just disappointing in my opinion. So I recently came across Signature Hound, which I guess at some point had been charging for email signatures, but decided to just make it free for everyone. So it's amazing. All the features that you want are basically there. So you can style it. Every single element has something that you can tweak around it. So it's great. So what you're going to do is you're going to sign up for a free account and you're going to create a new signature. You're going to call it whatever you want to call it. So as you can see, there's like a template here. That's what this single column looks like. And you're going to scroll. Basically, you're going to go step by step through all the different items in this left-hand menu until you've gone through them all and you've customized it as much as possible. So this one seems to me is really long. I like a more compressed email signature, but it's completely up to you. All of these different options are up for grabs. So I like this one. I'm so used to that line running through between your photo or your logo and the rest of the text that this is my go-to. So now we're going to go here and you can select your image. If you want to use an image, you can. If you don't want to, you don't have to. You can toggle that off basically so it doesn't show. But there's a setting later on where you can basically swap out your logo with your profile picture. There we go. So you're just going to play around with how large you want that to be. That looks okay, I think. And you're going to change all the settings to your settings. So you can just simply clear out whatever you don't want to use so that it's empty and or type it in. Again, I don't put my phone number in my signature, but it's completely up to you. Then you're just, once you have this part done, the rest of it's going to come in the other tabs, or you're just going to keep going down the tabs. I don't want to put a logo, so I'm just going to toggle that off. I don't need a company name. I don't need an address. I'm just going to replace it with my email, website. And then you can set all the different social media accounts that you want. Twitter, I don't use Twitter, so I'm just going to remove that one like that. It's not clear, sorry, it's this toggle, like remove. Let's pretend that's correct. I don't want to have to take you through all of it. And then design. This is where there are tons of degrees of freedom here. So if you want to, I toggled that on so that my picture is aligned with the rest of the content. If you don't want icons for your email or your website, I want that. Icon type, I like this kind, but you can, actually let's do that kind. Actually, no, let's do that. But you can see there's a lot of options here, which is awesome. Icon size, you can make it larger, smaller. I like these with the circle around them. They kind of all look more uniform in my opinion. And now you're just going to keep going down. You want to remove that divider. I like it. You're just going to start adding your colors. I don't like the text in gray, so I'm just going to go black. Font. Usually there aren't too many options, but there are enough options, I think, here. I'm fine with Arial. If you want a serif font, there's some options here. I'll just leave it as it was. You can even remove this that says created with Signature Hound. Call to action. this is basically like an image below your email signature. So I'm just going to use an example. I'm just going to upload that email signature we made in Canva just so you see what it's like. So you see it's a pretty large image underneath, and you can obviously make it smaller. What's cool about this is that that image has its own unique link. So if you're promoting something, you have a launch, you're selling like a new course, a new book, something, you can put an element down here to kind of let people know that that's going on, and you can remove it later on. So in that sense, it's pretty cool. I personally don't need it for my email signature that's going out all the time, so I'm just gonna remove that. But it is a pretty nice feature to have. And then disclaimer, I don't use disclaimers, but I understand that a lot of people need it. You can type in your unique disclaimer there, and then you're done. So it's auto-saving all the time, just so you know, you don't have to click save. And what you're gonna do at this point to install it in Dubsado is click install signature. And there are a lot of options here. So if you want to use the same signature in your Gmail, you can. You just follow the instructions. For Dubsado, as you can see, it's not listed here. So what you're going to do is you're going to copy the signature as a source code. And it's going to give you a warning, but that's fine. Like, Dubsado isn't listed here, so just copy. Now in Dubsado, you're going to come back to the same location. Templates, canned email, signature. And you're going to go into code view, and you're going to paste that there. I know it looks a little bit scary if you're not used to it, but you know, it's there. So if you toggle that code view, you can toggle it on and off, and it's there, it's done. Yes, there are these weird gray lines, but I promise you that your clients are not gonna see it. You're gonna see it all the time. So even when you're sending emails and you click here, let me show you. It's easier just to show you. I'll go to projects again, my sample clients. I'm gonna send an email. As you can see, the gray lines are still there. So even when you're writing an email, it's gonna show up there, and I get it, it looks weird, but I'm gonna send myself an email just so you can see that it will not appear when at your client's end. So I'm in my personal email account, and you can see that I received this email. I am not seeing those gray lines, even though I was seeing them in Dubsado. And each of these elements are clickable. Yes, I didn't set these correctly. They're still the ones from Signature Hound, but if I click on this, it does take me to my website. So that's the beauty of creating an email signature inside an email signature generator. Each of these individual elements will be clickable and will send people to that unique link. So you have a lot of information, about you and your business, your social icons, your website, your address, everything that you want in a very compact space so that clients or leads or anyone who's receiving that email can reference to that very easily. So I hope this was helpful. If you need support with your Dubsado setups, you can always reach out to me. Go to my website, emmaketiraee.com, and you can click book a call to book a call with me to learn more about how I can help you with a full Dubsado setup, or also with Dubsado updates. If you need to tweak a workflow, you need help with form design, any of those things, I can help you. So reach out and book a consult. So see you next time.